Right, declarations of interest for this part of the council. Councillors are asked to consider if they have an interest in this part of the council.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to declare interest in the items in relation to the Merseyside Fire Rescue Authority. I was at a meeting at the authority last week and I've made my decision and I voted accordingly, and hence I'll be leaving the council chamber during that debate here tonight.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to do the first. I'm to just as an item of 7C, Fusion Valentine, 5 of Magenta, and also the Merseyside.
Yeah, I should accept the same in item 7C by the virtue of my motion.
Thank you.
Moving on to petitions.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor. I've got two petitions. The first is 91 signatures for people living in Cumbria Drive in Longbury, asking that Wirral Council take action to address issues related to speeding, volume of traffic, and neglect of the road service. And another petition, Mr. Mayor, of 138 signatures from residents of Castle Grove in Rockbury, requesting that measures be taken by Wirral Council to reduce speeding vehicles along the road. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Councillor. Service cannot play its part if it's starved of talent and resources. I would like to link some of the 2020 themes to our campaign. Children and young people. Wirral Libraries have hitherto provided an invaluable service to children through early years book packs, liaison with schools, baby bounce and rhyme sessions, summer holiday clubs and summer reading challenges. Over 10,000 young people were involved in this last year. Many children and young people use the libraries as safe places for homework, projects and research. This massively improves their life chances, especially in the poorer areas. We now have no specialist children's librarians working within any of our 24 libraries. Community hubs. The NHS has flagged up as underlying causes of many illnesses treated at GP and walking centres stem from isolation and loneliness. Libraries represent friendly and reliable places for people to visit. They are becoming hubs for social inclusion, and they host a broad range of activities across the whole community. These include photographic and art exhibitions, poetry clubs, reading circles, family history groups, local history societies, community cinemas, parent and toddler groups, Tai Chi classes, knitting circles, and many more activities vital for maintaining social cohesion. The quality of life offer. Libraries don't just lend books, they promulgate reading, literacy and cultural inclusion through reading groups, literacy classes, creative writing groups, talks by local and national authors, and many more ventures. Digital inclusion. Central and local governments now demand that we communicate with you by way of digital media. Our librarians have been trained as digital champions to assist the public. 30% of rural residents do not have access to broadband in their own homes and increasingly rely on libraries for computer access. Is this the time to reduce trained staff and opening hours? Finally, volunteering. Friends groups have always maintained that there should be a role for volunteers in supporting library staff, but not in replacing them. Our chairman, Professor Robert Lee, has repeatedly requested that the council should work with friends groups to put in place a new framework for our library service. I would ask all elected members and senior officers to seriously consider our campaign call and enter into a genuine and open dialogue with the friends board. Thank you for your attention.
Policy and Performance Committee next week, which is meetings on the 15th. On the opening hours changes, and members are being happy in front of progress through this monitoring and scrutiny process. As part of ongoing staff consultation on these changes, a number of dedicated library staff have been reintroduced to support the library service work, and the service will keep this under review. And finally, Mr. Mayor, our library service will continue to develop its strategy and plans going forward, and we are committed to that being in full consultation with the friends groups across the board. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor Beaton.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. May I also thank Mr. Oliver for bringing this petition to council and his articulate speech and showcasing what libraries actually do and showing the value of them. Mr. Mayor, this chamber has heard me on numerous occasions stand up for our community libraries and how important they are as an asset to each individual town and village. I'm not going to rehash the arguments that I've previously made as a threat of closure or opening hours. What I will say, Mr. Mayor, is I'm actually quite saddened that we lost a great opportunity last year to undertake a comprehensive review of our services and then how they can be effectively managed for seamless service for rural residents. Last year, after Future Council, we saw a variety of opening hours in place on local libraries without even asking any staff or user groups. And yes, it was a mistake, yes, it was admitted, and yes, a prompt withdrawal was made and a consultation took place. But it does show the careless nature in which this council treats our library staff and our library users. And this can be demonstrated as well by a volunteer agreement that library users groups have been waiting for the past 6 months. That's still not drawn up, that's still not in place yet. And it can also be demonstrated when staff sickness that my own library there has been closed twice on Saturday due to staff sickness in the Wallasey village a couple of weeks ago was as well. Mr. Mayor, last December I pressed upon this council to come up with a library strategy to ensure that all our citizens have access to a library within reasonable timescales. And this hasn't happened yet, and libraries are linking along, doing their best with the pricing of opening hours. I'm quite surprised that you haven't remembered in his speech, didn't mention this, but a mayor has gone out to library friends groups outlining a library framework. Now, sadly, the library service manager said to these people that this isn't going to be an individual strategy for libraries, but an overarching culture and leisure strategy. And while I do welcome the council and the cabinet member giving more thought to libraries and how we can grow the membership, give a better service, I'm disappointed it's taking quite long to do so. And there's nothing in this draft framework that gives any rationale about how the council is going to go about it and what time scales, and there's no mention of a specific budget. Mr. Mayor, this petition does show how important libraries are to rural communities. In fact, added to the petition that individual libraries gave to the Future Council, it comes remarkably close to those who took part in the entire consultation. I do ask that the leader of this council and the cabinet member take some strong leadership on this issue and take charge of shaping the library service that's fit for the future. Unfortunately, the bad handling of the situation last year has left user groups waiting for a solution with no confidence. Let this not be the case. Let's do a full scrutiny review. Let's take the time for elected members, chief officers, to meet with the user groups, and together we can come up, as Mr. Arley said, with a strong dialogue and a strong strategy that will withstand the test of time. So we're not here again in the next 12 months issuing the same concerns. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to thank the organiser of the petition for speaking succinctly and in detail about the problems the library service faces. And I remind members that the 64 Act still requires us to have a comprehensive library service, and it's that I'm anxious about. But I also thank the Cabinet Member for drawing attention to the report going to the Scrutiny Committee, because I read the report that's now on the server and it's produced by a business analyst. Now, I don't know whether that is significant, but I'm anxious that it has the bones of statistics but not the feeling on the ground. And what I'd like to see, Mr. Mayor, is when the Scrutiny Committee do meet, officers attending and give some detail about where the difficulties are. Not producing your report that covers the issues, but sadly appears rather complacent in its context. Could I also ask that when the committee meet, they also get access to some of the internal memos about how the service might operate? Because in paragraph 4.23 of that report, it talks about activities, administrative tasks at the discretion of the relevant manager. The word discretion is significant. It also talks about some consideration being given to allow staff to remain with their current patch. So it's clear that there are occasional closures at short notice, and that staff do have to compensate by moving around. But breaking that link between key staff and their community and the knowledge of the individuals attending the library and the services they need is, regret to say, a downgrading of the service. So, Mr. Mayor, I hope this petition is the first stage in a thorough discussion at the scrutiny committees, and it isn't perhaps parked and not discussed in detail. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Is that good?
Yeah.
Agreed.
I will approve those minutes. Moving on to item 6, leaders, executive members and chairs reports. Item 6 on page 41 to 76 of the agenda contains the reports of the leader of the cabinet, members and scrutiny annual reports. The council is invited to receive and note these reports. The cabinet's portfolio holders will not present their reports, which will be taken as read. All questions must be confined to the contents of the report. Questioners, please ensure that your question is no longer than 2 minutes. The total number of questions on any one report will not normally exceed more than 5 minutes. Responses to questions will be reserved to the conclusion of all questions on a particular report. Cabinet members, please ensure your responses do not exceed 10 minutes. Now, are there any questions which the councillors wish to ask in respect of the leader's report? Councillor Reid.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Can I ask the legal counsel in relation to the 2020 plan whether it's true that despite having been suspended by the Labour Party nationally, that the leader doesn't see the need to suspend 2 Labour councillors from this period of Wirral, and that it's about governance, you said. It all talks about governance. Good governance. Hopefully, my question time is not being delayed. And, Mr. Mayor, can I ask, the 5-year plan is aligned to the terms of the new Conservative government. Does the council need to agree with Andy Burnham's assessment that the Labour Party cannot assume the general election as its lowest point? He said it will be coming increasingly irrelevant if it doesn't respond to people's concerns. And he went on to say that the Labour Party has lost its emotional connection with many people, and that people look at Labour and don't see people they can relate to. How does he address those legitimate concerns within the 2020, his 2020 document? Is there any other questions to the leader's report before I...
Just say what was asked.
No, okay, Councillor Collins.
Okay, on the first part of Jeff Green's question about the suspensions, I've nothing to add to the comments of the Lord Solicitor, Mr. Mayor. On the second part of the question, the quote from Andy Burnham, my take on this, Mr. Mayor, is the Labour Party, the Labour Group in Wirral, have a resounding...
Yes.